Okay, now let's just get into this evidence coming out of the United States of America. Now, a couple of weeks ago, we had the CAS report in the UK. Now we have this. And we can clearly see that the LGBTQ frequency, it has broken, right? This frequency that they were pushing on people, it has officially been broken. And I hope YouTube is paying attention, because to break a frequency, you don't require numbers, right? Let us continue with the evidence. The date of the evidence is June 9th, 2024. American College of Pediatricians issue fiery statement condemning child gender transition. The American College of Pediatricians and other groups argue evidence does not support transgender medical procedures are best for gender dysphoric children and adolescents. It is good that these people are coming out and speaking out, right? But how did we get here? Why was this thing allowed to reach this far? Why did so many people, educated people, intelligent people, sit around and allow this agenda to reach this far? Why? Right? Those are important questions. And it says a lot about us as a people, right? That is supposed to be intelligent, well-read, well-spoken, but you sit and allow this agenda to reach this far. Even to the point where politicians that you voted for, they are creating laws to strip parental rights. How did it reach this far? And why did we allow it to reach this far? Let us continue with the evidence. A coalition of pediatricians, health policy groups, and conservative organizations is calling on medical professionals to stop promoting transgender medical treatment for children. The American College of Pediatricians and allied groups styling themselves as Doctors Protecting Children have published a declaration urging mainstream American medical associations like the American Academy of Pediatrics to abandon support for so-called gender-affirming care for transgender youth. It's about time. It's about time. And I'm so happy that people are waking up to what this agenda is and what it is doing to the West, right? And when you see these people are moving at such a pace, you realize that they have suddenly been given the wake-up call. Because this type of thing is not happening in China. It's not happening in Russia. They are not subjecting their children to this agenda. So why is it in the West we are subjecting our children, which is our future, to this agenda? Why? And creating laws to enable it to happen. Why? Right? It should have never been allowed to happen in the first place. And it just goes to show you spiritual wickedness. Right? It goes to show you the spiritual war we are involved in. Please do not take for granted that we are at war. We wrestle not with flesh and blood. And one of the first things they've got to do is to separate you from your God. And they have used this agenda to separate you from your God, to remove the Most High of the land. So you will be a people in the West that is easy to conquer. Your town, your city, your state will be easy to invade, and you'll be easy to round up, because you won't have the Most High to protect you. And that is why they were pushing it. And you've got to examine the people you are voting for. And I keep telling you all, stop voting. When you vote, you hand over your free will. And these people are acting on your behalf, and they are creating laws to enable various agenda that does not work in your favor. right? Understand that the LGBTQ God will not give you power and let you keep it. It always comes with a price. The LGBTQ God will not stand with you in battle. He will abandon you. The only one that will stand with the West is the Most High. And they have used this agenda, this poison chalice, right, to run him off the land. Because people, we cannot serve two masters. Either you're going to love one and hate the other, right? But you cannot serve two masters. And I'm happy that the West is waking up to the poison chalice that is the LGBTQ agenda. I'm glad that the West is waking up, right? Because they are looking to destroy our way of life. They are looking to destroy our religion, our family life. And we should not sit quietly and let it slide, right? Understand we are in a spiritual war. And understand how the enemy works, right? We need to seek the Most High, and we need to constantly pray. Do not underestimate prayer. Do not underestimate the enemy you have, because this enemy will stoop so low it's unbelievable. We need to pray and say, glory be to the Most High.